the Kubalik leads all rookies with 26 goals. Chicago has 18 more goals from rookies than any other NHL team. Back for Petrangelo. Swings it across to Ryan O'Reilly. To the goal mouth he goes, tapped in front by Perron. David Perron works it back. Schwartz across the shin. And 22 seconds of the power play. The Blues have grabbed the lead.
But you see they're going to work it around. David Perron's going to get it down low. Go to the bumper position. He can't get there. Go to Perron again. Schwartz, the Shen, the Saskatoon connection, and they just whip it to the back of the net. The guys just get it, move it, and finish it. Braden Shen.
Perron winds and shoots. That's blocked by Carpenter. Away shorthanded with Saad. Carpenter with Saad. Brandon Saad in. A bouncing puck. Shoots. And Binnington turns that away. Now center Binnington can't find it. Still loose. Carpenter trying to find it. Shot by Saad. Stopped by Binnington.
You know, maybe... shot selection a little off right now, but we're getting good opportunities.
Are you starting to get the feel that your team is getting primed for the playoffs?
Well, lately, the last 6-7 games, I believe, we've been playing that style of hockey with the reloading and the back checking and the hard play, physical play, so that's important to go into the playoffs.
Not very often will Ryan O'Reilly lose a draw cleanly, but he lost it cleanly, and because of that, time and space for Duncan Keith. And you can see some, a little block out by Taves. O'Reilly can't get out there, and that's just hammer time for Duncan Keith. 1-1. The Blues don't like it at all. They think there was some interference. I just think it's a face-off win and a great play by Duncan Keith.
The Blackhawks back to the playoffs. They missed last year for the second straight year. It made the postseason 9 previous times before that. Off the draw, back to Murphy. Got Murphy the time along. Rich shot scores! Murphy through the traffic, and just like that, the Blackhawks have taken the lead.
2 goals. He's going to battle for it. It's a 5-man commitment. Eventually, Murphy's going to get it, shoot it through a screen. Look who's right in front. The old graybeard, Jonathan Taves, taking away the vision of Jordan Binnington. Time and space. Binnington doesn't see it until it goes past it. But look at the extra effort by Taves right there to get it away from Robert Thomas. And rather than hanging out to the outside...
30 seconds to go in the Chicago power play. Kane to Kubalik. Shoots. Kicked out by Binnington. Now Kane. Back to Kane. To Kubalik. Flips that back to Keith. Cross he goes to Kane. Winding in. Shoots. Scores! Patrick Kane. A power play goal. And Chicago takes a 3-1 lead.
But watch this one. Keith to Kane. Slot screen. One by Falk, one by DeBrincat, and Jordan Binnington, he just can't see that puck. He can't find it come off the stick of Kane. All he does is respond to the puck going off the post and in. 3-1 Chicago.
After Kane, also popular here in St. Louis.
Yes.
Petrangelo across to Thomas. In comes Thomas, drops it back to Perron, shoots the Crawford, makes the stop on that. And hangs on.
You've been saying that a lot tonight about Corey Crawford, and you couldn't be more right, Gord.
Here's Thomas back with it. Centering pass, Perron in, shoots, that's blocked by Seeler. Long pass for Thomas, knocks it down, fires, scores! Robert Thomas, and the Blues are back with a goal.
That RoboCam's going to show you everything you need to see. Perron's going to get the puck. Alex Petrangelo's on the bench zone going far side, he's wide open. Perron hears him, Robert Thomas the beneficiary, he's just going to snap that by Corey Crawford. No resistance at all.
And Ryan Carpenter gains center ice, lines it across to Kane, and his puck is picked by Schwartz. Ahead to Shen with O'Reilly, in comes O'Reilly, shoots, scores! Ryan O'Reilly ties the game!
Never quits on the back check. Look at the heart, the desire. Stick on the ice. Doesn't let Kane get the puck. Quick transition to Shen. Shen finds O'Reilly. He makes no mistake. Going low blocker. That all starts with an excellent back check by Schwartz. Outstanding finish by O'Reilly and a creative play by Shen. Beautiful hockey by the Blues.
Ryan O'Reilly's 12th of the year. Picked up by Thomas, who Sanford shot scores! Jack Sanford! And the Blues
to grab the lead.
Shot. We'll see what he does. He stops, pops, pulls it to the inside, gets Corey Crawford leaning off the post. You see his head is up, pulls it, and as he pulls it, Crawford's going to move a little bit to his left, and that opens up the short side. This will give you a better idea. See the pull? He's going to move just a bit, and that little flinch opens it up for Zach Sanford.
Now Highmore with a shot. Boquist back to Keith, lines and shoots, deflected, bidding for the save, rebound, score! And back comes Chicago, Matthew Highmore ties it up.
But the old guy, Duncan Keith, again, finds a way to get that puck to the net. It gets deflected right there, I think by Nylander, comp hard to the net, and Highmore jumps on the loose change to tie this thing up. Good job by Boquist keeping the play alive. Keith's going to find a way to get it in. You see it change direction right there. That's what made it an awkward save opportunity for Binnington. And Highmore never quits on the play. And he ties it up. Nice reward for a kid that played 5 years in the Quebec Major Junior League right there.
10 seconds to go in the Chicago power play. Doc has a look. Feeds it down to Strome. Strome sends it side, shoots, scores! Inside the power play, and Chicago is back on top.
You'll see him just staring, buys time, and by moving his feet, he'll drive everything up high. Then you see Strome with the puck. Everybody's puck watching, and nobody's paying attention to Sod, and he'll get that relay and just put it up and over the blocker of Jordan Binnington. Beautiful hockey by the Chicago Blackhawks, and a great job of composure.
Kane trying to move it across the line, picked up by Falk, lead pass for O'Reilly, he's got Schwartz with him. O'Reilly in, shoots, a glove save made by Corey Crawford. First time this year the Blues have allowed 3 power play goals in a game. Not sure we're done here yet. Falk shoots, score! No, we're not!
Wow. And we'll show you why coaching matters in a second. Really good strike by Ryan O'Reilly. Gets that over to Justin Falk, who hammers it home. Usually Alex Pietrangelo's on the ice with Carl Gunnarsson. Gunnarsson does not have nearly the shot of Justin Falk. So Mike Van Ryan says, you know what, it's the end of the penalty kill. I'm going to go with an offensive force. He shoots it off the lid.
And Thomas got back on Tate. Jonathan Toews picks it free, tries to throw it back in front, and Thomas has it back. Final second down the power play, Thomas works in. Rink wide pass, Brickle tees it up, Sanford is shot, Crawford the save, rebound, loose, Sanford, two, score! Zach Sanford, power play goal!
In name now, but you will soon. Zach Sanford's just starting to come into his own. The last month and a half, he's completely separated from a lot of other young players because of his strength, his shooting ability, desire to have the puck, and he's got the pure finishing touch. Gets that off through traffic and just finds a way to fool Corey Crawford. There's his first attempt. Doesn't hang out. Goes to the front of the net and just snaps it the long side.
To break it for Tate. Banks it back for Kane. To Keith, winds and shoots, tip, Binnington makes the stop. And on a wild night in St. Louis.